साउंड एक्शन
भाई बोलना कहता
अच्छा स्टोक 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 जाएगा मेरा भाई
स्टोक दे
Hi guys, this is Loki from Team Wanderers.
Saranbir from Team Wanderers.
All right, so Saran, you know we are into the season for Stok now. Do we want to spend some time today and talk about the things to carry for Stok?
What of course. Say? Yeah, we should. Before we get to the list of things to carry for Stok, it's important for us to understand the rucksack that we need for a trek like Stokkangri. So, like if this you can see from here till here, I've made sure I've known as my backs as I've taken the rucksack.
There are more details if you guys want to check on the rucksack, there's a link below.
Okay, I'm starting from head to toe for the things to carry for the Stokkangri trek. So when you will be trekking in the sunlight, at that time you will be requiring to carry a sun cap with you. The moment you reach the camp or it's getting cold, you will need to have a woolen cap for your head or even a balaclava that could be covering your head as well as your neck. Apart from this, you can additionally carry a muffler that you can wrap around on towards your neck whenever you feel cold, that is probably in the night or in the daytime. Coming further down towards the upper part, we will be wearing, so I'll be carrying with me three quick dry t-shirts half sleeves along with three quick dry t-shirts full sleeves.
And why three?
So what I generally prefer doing is each day when I'll be trekking, I'll start with a full sleeves quick dry t-shirt. I'll pair it up with a half sleeves quick dry t-shirt along with a track pant, that's also a quick dry one. Because first 3 days, I know it's not going to be that super cold and the trekking time that I'll be trekking is in the daytime. It's not in the night and I'm assuming it'll be a clear weather as
so
well.
So you are saying no base layer?
No, so for these 3 days when I'll be starting the trek, from Stok village to Changma, to Mankarmo and to Stok base, all the way till there. If the weather is super cold, then I might need to add on, but other than that, what I'll be comfortable in will be these 2 layers.
So I'll add on to that. Keep your base layer handy while we crossing the passes. We might need to add a layer after pulling it out from the day pack.
Of course. So to add on that layer, you can have a fleece. So I have two fleeces with me. This is a little thin one compared to this. This is a thick fleece, the grey one, that I'll be wearing at the campsite at the end of the each day's trek. If I'm feeling further cold, I might add on a jacket to it. But again, depending on my the understanding of the temperature outside, I'll choose to wear a fleece.
Yeah, I prefer a down jacket. It's comfortable for me. I avoid wearing fleece. But again, to each his own.
Of course. After this, I'll come straight towards the bottom layers. Like I mentioned earlier, I will be wearing quick dry track pants. So a total of 3 track pants is what I'll be carrying. 2 of them are going to be the quick dry track pants that I'll be wearing again on the first 3 days. The night when I'll be attempting the Stok, for that I will need a little thicker track pant, which is also windproof, wind resistant as well as water resistant. It has a zip towards the sides for both sides, just in case I want ventilation. Other than that, below this I will be wearing my base layer for down. So these two I'll club in when I'll be starting the expedition in the night. Along with that, for top, I'll be wearing a thermal for up. Along with that, I will be wearing 1 or 2 quick dry t-shirts, 1 fleece and a jacket. This jacket is going to be wind cheater thick. It has a layer of fleece inside as well. Again, like Lokibai mentioned earlier, he prefers to wear his down jacket at that time as well. I will prefer wearing something like this. This is a hard shell outside.
But this works.
This actually works really good because if you have an additional jacket, maybe like a feather jacket or down jacket, after the trek you can wear it.
Sure.
So this, on the other hand, if by the time you come back down, if it becomes wet in terms of your slide and stuff, you have that second alternate pair as well, right?
Absolutely.
Anyways, when I'll be trekking, apart from this, I will also be carrying either a poncho that's going to be there in case if the weather goes bad up over there on the Stok, or a wind cheater or a rainproof jacket for the top.
So just to add here guys, when you're layering up for Stokkangri, remember use for the summit push, you'll be starting sometime post midnight or around midnight depending on the
speed,
the group speed. So please be mindful of the fact that you'll be layered up while you start for the trek. And you know, after a kilometer two, you'll start probably feeling a little hot. So, you need to probably layer down then. But once again, I mean, it's about the Stok weather, so no one can predict that.
Just one thing I'd like to add on over here. So there was a case in the last season that we had. One of the trekkers, Shayoni, I believe. So what she had done, Sayanti. What she had done was, when she was there on the summit, just before the summit actually, when she was trekking in the night, she felt the need that the weather is getting a little warm, so that's why she let go of her layers and especially her gloves.
Wow.
That is when she caught up a little bit of cold and she felt a little heaviness on her chest as well. And unfortunately, she had to descend. So depending the time when you have to actually let go of the layers is also very important. If you are able to decide for yourself, good. If not, by then your trek leader, again, like with the wanderers, will definitely tell you this is the right time for you to let go of your layers or no. So make sure you follow your trek lead's instruction at that expedition night, very seriously follow it, yeah? Okay, so apart from this, I will have 3 layers of cotton socks, cotton towel socks. I do not need to invest in those blister-free socks or other any other kind of a sock. Normal cotton towel socks are more than enough. I can wear even one for 2 days or 3, again, depending on my own hygiene.
Yeah, it's about your personal hygiene. You can carry 5 of them if you wish.
So we suggest carry not more than 3. Apart from that, this is a thick pair of socks. This is woolen from the top and inside is fleece. This I will be wearing in the night when I'll be sleeping in the tent, in the campsite. I will not be wearing this when I'll be trekking any day, especially even in on the night when I have to do the expedition to Stok. Why? Because this will be excessive warm. Yeah. And excessive warmth I will require only when my body is not generating heat that is inside the tent. As I trek, even if my feet are cold, that's perfectly fine to start with. But eventually, my feet will automatically exit that heat and my feet will be nice and warm. Yeah? A very important thing, glove. So for a trek like Stok Kangri, you do not require the basic gloves, the thin line gloves. These are gloves that I have here, which are thick. They have a fleece layering inside as well. And they're water repellent or probably even waterproof. I need a good pair of gloves because when I'll be attempting the summit, my hands, I need to make sure that I have good control. If I feel excessive cold in my hands, especially, again, extremities, you have to keep them warm. Hands is one of those. So if I have, let's say, a thin pair of gloves, it will not keep my hands warm. I will tend to feel more cold and I will not be able to make it to the summit.
Yeah, the most important point of the entire trek is the night when you're going for the summit push. So on that night, you have to keep yourself warm, you know, active enough to hold on to the trek pole properly. You know, you're crossing the boulder. You first negotiate the glacier patch, then you cross over the boulders. So it's a tricky terrain. It's not going to be easy. But again, I mean, if you're well prepared, you'll be able to make it to the summit.
Cool. So I also will be carrying these as my trekking shoes. These are hard, rigid trekking shoes. Compared to the earlier ones that we had showed, again, in the links below, you can see there are options that we've shared for trekking shoes. These are the ones that we recommend because A, they not just have the Vibram sole, they're also very sturdy for a trek like Stok Kangri, for a summit like Stok Kangri. If we need to add micro spikes or crampons, these are very good make sure they have a good grip on crampons. So these are the shoes that I will be suggesting that even you guys, if you guys can carry it, then go for
See,
it.
Some people forget the part that you need to have a pair of trekking shoes for Stok Kangri that are compatible to a crampon. Okay, so without which it won't work. So we need to make sure that our shoes are perfect for the Stok Kangri trek. We can also rent it from Leh, or we can try and rent it at the base camp location. But as I said, I mean, it has to be compatible to the crampons.
So again, over the past few years, what you've seen is at the Stok base, you get those mountaineering boots, the big heavy ones along with the crampons.
I'll show you guys that.
So those shoes might not be comfortable for everyone, but yeah, those are the shoes that are available, that could be available at the Stok base. They're very heavy. If you're mountaineers, you're used to them, there's nothing like it. But otherwise, for a first timer, wearing shoes like these, which are very hard and rigid, will be a little difficult. So yeah, that is why we suggest a trek shoe that can maybe have a fitted patch for your crampons or a micro spikes is better than having this one.
Again, I mean, these really keep you safe, while you're going through the boulders and negotiating the glacier. But again, to each his own. All right, another important piece of equipment is your day pack.
So this day pack I will be carrying with me the night I'll be attempting the summit. I will be carrying my water bottles in this, the duration that our team wanderers will be giving me. eatables, some chocolates, some biscuits, some juices, everything will be in that. Along with that, when I start that night's trek, the summit, I will be having this. This is my head torch, rather than this, a hand torch. The benefit of this is when I'll be trekking in the night, my hands will be free. Yeah, so then I know I can have a trek pole in my hand, or I can hold my rucksack properly, or however I want my hands to be free. This I will be carrying with me in the night whenever I'm moving here and there in the campsite, and not for the summit. So this and this.
That's a no. That's for sure.
This is a no for the expedition night as you're attempting the summit.
And again, Ladakh, you really you can't be very sure about your battery backup. So have a spare set of batteries for your headlamp. Quickly coming back to the day pack, also remember there's no water source on the final day of summit push. So you have to be mindful of the fact and use your water wisely, or if there is a need to share it.
There are some trekkers who ask us, is it mandatory for us to carry trek poles? See, trek poles, I'll just give you a little brief, otherwise there's an article also that we have on the website. So trek poles are your third point of balance. So we balance our bodies on left and right. If I have a third one, this is my third point balance. If I have this one, so this is going to be my 4-point balance when I trek. So the benefit of having a trek pole is whenever I'll be trekking, especially that night when we are attempting the summit, I will have a proper grip when I'm walking, right? Some people prefer that this could be a hindrance, so it's not something that they can carry. They cannot, walk in this. For some, this becomes a very important piece of equipment for trekking. So we recommend it's good for you to carry one. If you're finding it comfortable to use, go for it. If not, the moment you think it's uncomfortable, find a patch that is plain. Let your trek leader let us know, or probably if you can do it yourself, or seek help from your fellow trekkers. Make sure you put it back on the rucksack if it's being a hindrance to you. If not, keep trekking with it. Yeah. So these two trek poles are also, again, like we just mentioned, it's not mandatory, but it's good if you can have this as your third and fourth point of balance.
From my experience, it's a good to have a thing.
Yes. Yeah. So these are the basic things that we suggest that you need to carry. Other than this, again, if you tend to feel that, you feel excessive cold, or are these layers meant for me or no, or if you have any doubts post this video, please feel free to again give us a call. Our numbers will be mentioned down.
Most of this information is also available on the website. You can take a look at that.
Cool. Anything else if you guys have, again, like I mentioned earlier as well, please feel free to write down below if you need any assistance from us. We'll be glad to help. It doesn't matter, you just are... Again, like we say, please do come again and trek with us as wanderers. But if you already registered with someone and you think that this video is helpful, but you have doubts, it's fine. Give us a call. We'll be really helpful, and we'll be wanting to assist you guys.
All right. So that's pretty much from us for today. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share it with others. And till then, this is Loki signing off.
Beer signing off from Team Wanderers.
Hasta la vista. Stok chalega bhai. Stok. तेरा भाई स्टोक चढ़ाएगा
स्टोक
व्हील का स्टोक